daydream, smoking on some OG. Well, I'm homegrown and I'm leaning on my love. My love.
Here he is, getting the bottle ready.
That's right. Every morning.
Baby bottle pop.
Baby bottle pop,
baby bottle pop.
Yeah, I remember.
Give it dicks, bacon, shake it. Ew, that's garbage. Baby bottle pops, ew.
So are like the, what are those little like white finger things you stick? Oh, dipping, dips?
Oh, fun dips?
Fun dips. I never really liked any of that stuff.
I can't believe we ate that. I didn't either, but I still had it.
Oh, I do not want to work out today.
Neither do I.
I couldn't get out of bed this morning.
It's ripping it off like a band-aid.
It's ripping it off.
I feel like it is every morning, to be honest. It's never like, wake up and like, yeah, let's go. I don't think
I feel that way when I go to bed at a decent time. And when I'm able to get up like an hour before the workout.
Yeah, but you still always like, it's work. I feel like that's why it's called working out. And so like, when you go, you're never like, this is gonna be
why is it
super
called working
fun.
Out?
Because you're working your muscles.
Working out your muscles?
I think.
What does that mean? Working out your muscles.
Like you're working them to like build strength.
Like working on?
I think it's called working out because it's like, yeah, I don't know. We should Google it. Why is it called working out?
Like working out your body. Oh, you're like tiring it out.
Like, yeah, but why would you want to do that?
When you wear down your muscles, that's how you build muscle.
Oh, you're wearing them down?
Yeah.
Okay.
I guess that's...
Why is it called working out? The word workout was originated from the 1890s. Comes from the word work, which means to do something.
Yeah.
So if you break down the word, anything that has to do with you putting out action, whether it's jumping, running, punching, or swimming, you are working out. Okay.
Stupid.
So stupid.
So
I mean,
stupid.
That's what we thought, right? Okay, we gotta go.
What time is it?
Skedaddle. I'm just bringing my coffee mug with me. It's like 8:10. We're gonna be late for a very important date.
Oh, fuck.
Okay, I don't have any hands. I need you to open that door. Here we go. I got it.
Baby bottle pop. Keys, right?
Why would I have the keys? I'm not the driver. I don't have the keys. Wait, do I have these? No, I don't have them.
You make it sound like you have them.
I make it sound like I have them. What driver on this planet doesn't go, oh, let me grab the car keys? I mean, I get it, but it's like, come on. We know you do the driving every day. So just grab the keys. I usually tell you.
If I have them.
I'll say, oh, I got the keys because I know you'll be looking for them. So if I don't say it, I'm assuming that you
But have. I mean, I would say more than half the time you have them in your purse.
Not really. I just think too, like you, like we know that you drive, so like technically it makes more sense for you to always
Jack
grab
is
the
out
keys.
There working hard every morning, all
Who?
Day.
Our neighbor?
Jack.
Across the street.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he is working out on his yard.
Mm-hmm.
So he's doing. Oh good, the recycling's coming today.
Mm-hmm.
Thank goodness. Except we still have a stack of boxes in the garage, don't we?
Our neighbor across the street. We'll call him Jack for this video. But
all he does is work on his yard.
Then he's retired. And he spends from like 7 a.m. to 6 p.m.
on the yard.
On the yard.
All day.
Every day.
All day.
Unless he has to like run an errand.
That looks so pale.
Mm-hmm.
Let's just switch up from your normal banana bread Lara bar.
Yeah. I'm gonna give Lara a break today.
Mm-hmm.
She's been working out hard.
Mm-hmm.
Did you ever get into Pez?
What, Marina? Pez?
Yeah, but like Pez dispensers, those are stupid.
I remember dabbling in those, but they sucked. Yeah, the candy was like no fun.
My dad likes those, he still likes them.
What were my favorite candies? Okay, I was never really a candy person. Even
what were those things called?
I liked Tootsie Rolls and Tootsie Pops.
What were those things that came out of the quarter dispensers? And it was like, there was like little yellow bananas. And like...
Oh, Pez. No, Runtz.
No? Are they Runtz?
Runtz. The bananas, like the different shapes. There's like bananas, different fruits, and they're different colors.
Yeah, those are called Runtz.
Candy coated, yeah. But
my dad
those aren't not very good.
I know, my dad likes weird candies.
Like, I understand, like, Sour Patch Kids, Sour Punch Straws, Strawberry. Ugh.
But, like, Pez isn't even a candy.
Pez is just, like, a brick of sugar. Well, I guess all of it is, but it's just, like, a compounded brick.
Remember Warheads?
Brick. Oh, yeah.
Do you remember Sprees or Shock Tarts?
Yeah, those are good. Shock Tarts are good. Like, if you're gonna go in... Oh, I guess I like all the tart candy. I'm like, oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Shock Tarts are good. I like
Sprees are good.
Sour Punch Straws. Sprees are good. They're just kind of like... You know what's good as chewy Sprees.
You like Sour Straws, huh? Here, have that.
Yeah, I like Sour Straws. What do you like for chocolate candies? I feel like you're not a big chocolate guy.
I like chocolate almonds.
Yeah.
Like Hershey's with almonds.
You like Hershey's, yeah. You don't like real chocolate.
I would get her. Well, if I, that is real chocolate. As you're a kid and you have chocolate options, Hershey's is a real chocolate.
Well, yeah, I mean like, Hershey's is kind of like fakey, you know?
What are you eating, like Toblerone or whatever the fuck it's called?
No, but I mean like, I've never seen you like a gourmet like chocolate.
Like what? Give an example, you can't.
I don't know.
And you're not gonna give like a gourmet example.
Like a local brand or something.
Right, you're asking me what my favorite chocolate is. Mm. You say a chocolate from a gas station.
Okay, true.
I didn't hear you say any kind of Sour Patch Gourmet is from
sorry
a local
brand.
Sorry
about that. Yeah,
brand.
You're true.
Stupid.
That's, okay, I'm sorry.
That's the dumbest thing I've ever heard.
Okay, so you like almonds. Do you like the Hershey's chocolate bar with the chocolate almond bar?
I used to eat the chocolate almond bar, okay, at school. That was like the only one of like the only good chocolate options in my mind.
They would sell that at your school?
In the cafeteria, as I get it. Like, you know, the station.
Did they sell candy at my school?
But I would get the chocolate Hershey's with almonds.
Yeah.
But only eat the pieces that had an almond in it. And then I'd give the chocolate breakoffs to my friends.
Was there, like, whole almonds?
Like my friends were, like, scavengers.
Yeah. And they'd wait for your chocolate drops?
Yeah, every day.
Really?
Yeah, and they knew I was gonna, like, break off my chocolate. And I would, like...
Oh, what?
I would only eat the pieces with almonds. And then they would just, like...
Oh, that's cute.
Eat my chocolate.
It's fun.
Same thing with my cheese sticks and what are those called? Mozzarella sticks?
Yeah.
That was like a big lunch serving at school.
Yeah.
And I wouldn't eat the ends for some reason.
Yeah.
I don't know, that's kind of weird now looking back, but I wouldn't eat the ends of my mozzarella sticks.
Weird.
And same thing, like friends like waiting for mice.
You're so weird.
I would eat it now, but looking back, I don't know why I didn't do it then. They like grossed me out. I think just like that cafeteria food in general grossed me out.
Oh my god, it's so bad. Did you eat at the cafeteria every day?
Probably like 4 out of 5 days a week.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
No, I didn't eat cafeteria food.
Sometimes I would get, we had like...
Our cafeteria food was like not good though. Like I would, it's like, I would not consider it like very edible.
Neither was ours, and that's why I would probably end up eating mozzarella sticks like 3 out of 4. 3 out of the 5 days.
You just lived on mozzarella sticks.
That's what everyone did. I mean, there wasn't like a good
meal. Because it was gross.
Meal.
Why don't you just pack a lunch?
I mean, I would some days.
You just pack a lunch is what I started doing. And then I would, well, starting after freshman year, you could go off campus, so I would just leave for lunch every day.
Dang, that's crazy. Yeah. We were never allowed to go off campus. And then our senior year, I had like off campus like class for like I would go coach PE at one of the elementary schools for one of my periods, and then I would just pick up lunch on the way back.
I feel like that's some Texas rules, like
no off campus lunch,
kinda like a little bit strict.
Well, I mean,
they don't want you getting in any trouble.
The school zone speed limit in Texas is like 2.
No, totally. It's really strict. California, I mean, it does make sense because people go and get stoned at lunch and then go back.
Of course.
You know, so.
not surprised, but I mean, I wouldn't do that, but I would go get sandwiches and go to like Petaluma Market.
My girlfriend in high school would make me lunch on Fridays. Cause oh, that was nice. Like, that was like game day. And so yeah. She'd make me like a sack lunch. That's actually a funny.
So that's your one day that you didn't eat the cafeteria food. Yeah.
Exactly. No, there was classic. There was some days I did make my lunch, and then every once in a while my mom would like make me something.
Yeah, well your mom, I mean, no shade on your mom, she's busy.
Yeah. No, I wasn't, no, I'm saying, you were saying I should make shit myself, because you did.
Yeah. Just like,
and there was some days that yourself. There was some days that I did, but it would just be like something basic, like a PB&J or something.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah, but what would you I make do have a funny story though. I don't know if I've ever told you this. Is that my ex-girlfriend, she would make me lunch every day, or every Friday during football season. And she would make this like delicious, like fried chicken, like buffalo chicken wrap for me.
Yeah.
Okay. And
that's great.
One Friday, I went to, like, she would give it to me. I'd put it in my locker, go to class. At lunchtime, I'd go pick it up from my locker.
Would she give it, would she serve it with chips?
Yeah, I think like Lay's.
Yeah.
So I need the details. Yeah, so I, one day I was going to lunch and I went by my locker, grabbed my bag, and you know how you like look into your sack when you're like walking to lunch, kind of getting excited, like what's all in here today? Well, the chips were in there and like the gummies were in there, but the wrap was not in there.
Nothing worse.
And I was like, I texted my girlfriend, or I saw her, I don't know if we're in the same period, I was like, hey, like, I saw that in here this morning, right? You packed me, I'm not going crazy. And she's like, yeah, I did. And so I went to the office, and I was like, hey, like, someone's been in my locker, and someone stole my wrap out of my locker. My buffalo chicken wrap, like, someone stole it.
Wait, what?
And I was really cool, like, me and the principal were, like, friends. Like,
yeah.
You know, they're really cool with me. And so they're like, let's hop on the cameras and look. And we pulled up the cameras, and sure enough, a guy walked by my locker, opens it up,
and took your
pulls
wrap?
My sack out, reaches his hand
Shut
in, takes
up.
It up, starts eating it at my locker, and then like closes it and walks away.
What?
Yeah. And then the kid got in trouble and had to go like to the office.
He stole your lunch?
That was my senior year, I think, actually.
Oh my god, he must have really wanted it. Mm-hmm. Is he hungry? Like, Tongries.
Yeah. And I was like, look, I don't care.
Like,
I'm not gonna try. I'm like, I'm just so curious. Like,
no, totally.
Was it one of my friends like effing with me?
Well, it's so weird. It's such a small, like, minute thing that's like so random. You're like, where did it go? Like, am I going crazy? Or like something happened, right?
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Then you get so curious. And that is
it
so
was like
funny.
Always someone that wanted to figure things out.
Oh, yes.
I wanted to get down to the bottom of stuff, and so I had to figure out what happened.
Kind of loud, it's raining.
Yeah, after worked out. All right, workout completed.
Complete. It was so humid in there because it's storming out. We were dripping sweat, but it was a good one.
We were planning on going on a little hike today, but it started raining on the way to the gym, so
yeah.
It's still really muggy, so I doubt we'll go on a hike.
And it'll probably be muddy and like,
right.
Yeah. Oh, hello. But that was good. Do you like when the exercises change really often?
Yeah.
Sometimes it's annoying because it's like you're scrambling to get in the next position and you only have like 5 seconds to like do it.
Do you like when it's exercises changing often with like a little bit of break, or do you like it when it's like three of the same exercise?
Three of the same.
With a lot of changes still and like no breaks at all throughout the whole time.
I prefer that.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah, because then you can like really like master the technique of the one and like go harder versus just trying to scramble to get to the next position.
But I do like days like today where it's just a bunch of exercises and you're kind of working out. The reason for that is for more cardio.
No,
you
totally.
You move around so much.
Yeah, definitely gets your heart rate.
Like a lot of burpees and a lot of like up and downs and mountain climbers. And it's just...
I get so red when I work out. You don't get red.
Why is it just trying
I get
right
red tomato fish club.
I don't really get red, I just, well, sometimes I do, I get like a head rush, depends. I'm gonna go down one more.
Okay.
Cool.
Cool. I need to get some niacinamide on this, maybe.
Some what?
Some niacinamide on my skin.
Niacinamide?
Niacinamide. Oh. Helps with like spots.
By the way, when's our facial?
Today.
What time?
2.
It's about 1:45.
Yeah.
And we've been doing work like ever since we got back home from the gym, and we just showered at 1:30, like 15 minutes ago. But we're heading to get facials.
Hydrafacials,
so.
So needed.
We've showed y'all getting them before, but it is what it is. We'll take you with this again. goes with me everywhere.
Bascom Trident vibes. Sorry, I know you guys don't like me chew gum on camera. I know it's annoying, but I forget. You know, you don't think about those things, like you just live your life and the camera's there and then you don't even realize it till you guys leave it in the comments and we're like, oh shoot. But like, if you're a normal person without a camera, you wouldn't even think about that. You forget.
While you're getting yours?
Yeah.
There's a place that just announced a liquor store. They just announced that they got a bunch of Blantons and Wellers in. So cool. It's over kind of by where it is. And perfect. So I'm gonna go check it out.
Okay, great.
So I'm sure many of y'all have.
Me to go first?
Yeah, husbands or boyfriends that are into whiskey and bourbon, and maybe you are as well, ladies. But one fun part about drinking bourbon is like collecting
is the hunt down
for the bottles themselves.
Yeah,
like
it's like a fun adventure.
Some are like rare, or some are like obviously more allocated where they're harder to find. And when a place nearby announces that they have some, like, you just gotta like get out of your seat and go, or you miss it. Like literally they'll have like 10 bottles of something and it's bought within like a few minutes. Mm-hmm. So
did they just announce it?
They announced it an hour ago, so it's
probably already gone.
But they got a lot. They got like E.H. Taylor, Blanton's, they got a couple different types of Weller.
Okay.
They announced something, you gotta go. Gotta go pull the trigger.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna do that while Joey's getting her done. I'll take you with me. Or you can stay with Joey for the facial. But the hunt is fun. And usually if they have like a bunch of allocated bottles, like different types of rare bottles, you can only go in and buy one bottle. And so usually I take Julie with me and I have her buy a bottle too.
Pretend we're brother and sister. How excited are you to drink bourbon again?
Honestly, like, I don't miss it.
You don't?
I don't miss like, I don't miss drinking alcohol, really.
Yeah, I know.
I think you kind of miss out when you're like
the experience of it.
Well, you miss out on experiences. Like, we've turned down hanging out with certain friends or going somewhere because we're on Rule 30.
Yep.
But, like, I don't know. I don't really miss drinking, like, at home. Like, a glass of bourbon. Right now, I'm sure I will once I
start back again.
Okay,
wait. Like, grab this. I just want to confirm. Alright, I just got my facial. I mean, you guys, this is insane. Look how, like, perfect. The skin is like glass. I'm not even kidding. After HydraFacial, it is. Oh, I just like love them. I don't know what it is, but it really like sucks everything out. I'm sorry I couldn't record in there. I mean, I should have, but I was taking stories and I just was like too overwhelmed. But one thing I always keep in the car is some brow gel. This one is just like an e.l.f. one. I literally just like whatever one I have that I can keep in here, I will throw in here. But I always, gosh, no, sorry, need brow gel for after situations like this, facials or working out, whatever, like the brows need to be up at all times. So I'm going the wrong way. Hunter is sending me back to the bourbon store to get another bottle of bourbon for him because one wasn't enough. He did find his bourbon and he's like, hey, do you think you could go get a bottle? Which I get it, like, you know, bourbon culture, it's like everyone does it. So I'm gonna go grab a bottle of bourbon and then he's getting his facial right now. But like, anyways, I'm so happy. I was really overdue for a nice skin clearing. And honestly, it's just like kind of nice to have someone do it for you. I don't feel like it's necessarily necessary. That was a funny way of saying that. But yeah, I just think it's like, instead of you having to keep your skin clear and like extract it, just having somebody do it for you. And the HydraFacial just does it in a way where it just sucks all of it out. It's kind of amazing. So, okay, I need focus, I need to drive. Wife of the year.
I grabbed a Blanton. It's a small one though. Small one because it's 375 milliliters instead of 750 or whatever it is.
Try your face.
But I grabbed the Blantons and then I got my facial. And while I was getting my facial, she went and grabbed a Weller for me.
because it's one per person, and she's a person, and I'm a person, so that's two.
She's a
and she drinks it with
Wait,
me.
Hunter, why's the door open? That's, that's your fault.
It probably is my fault.
You keep going out there. It's raining.
There could be a bird in our house.
Great. You can't do that.
Thank you.
Careful.
Thank you.
But yeah, so grab some good allocated bottles.
Yeah.
I have a half gallon of this already anyway, but it's nice to just like...
Yeah.
I want to like fill the shelf, like whatever I have, I want like a row of two or three behind it just to have. It's mostly for like guests and stuff. Oh, and then I grabbed a bottle of Class A Azul.
I feel like you really like Weller's too.
I do.
Yeah, but Class A Azul is the best.
It is. It's a really good sipper. We're over here buying alcohol and we're filling the Whole 30, but
yeah, we're just preparing for the exit of the Whole 30.
Maybe we'll take this to Florida with us, or we'll buy one in Florida. I bet I can find.
Yeah.
I bet we can go to a liquor store in Florida and get like some bourbon.
You think? I feel like, well, they have like, it's like bigger, a bigger state. And like, but don't people drink bourbon there?
I'm sure people drink bourbon everywhere.
Yeah.
It's like in Texas, I was able to find like the bottle that was like three times the size of this.
Give me parfait. Daily parfait. That's my favorite thing.
I'm gonna get the bigger bottle so you can see the difference.
Okay, I'll show you my parfait tutorial. It's really easy, but it's so good.
All right, this is the normal size. And this is the baby.
Oh yeah.
So. Not
that much of a difference.
I've been finding these a lot more than these.
The babies.
But even these, you're only allowed one, which is lame. It's like, that's...
But like, why do they even make that size? Just make it in
So this is the special reserve, the green bottle. I've been looking for a red bottle. And they had that too. And they said it was they had 24 bottles and they were the first 24 bottles to go.
The red ones?
Yeah, the red Weller.
What's your first drink gonna be after the Whole 30? I got it.
Probably, oh, I like putting it in this.
No, I like doing it. Don't
come live up. I thought we had some bigger strawberries. Oh, here they are.
Yeah, but you cut them up anyways.
I know, it's easier to cut. My first drink post Whole 30, either some bourbon on the rocks or Class A Azul on the rocks with an orange slice.
Yeah. I think I would almost rather have wine.
So I think tequila is like a good way to get back into drinking.
Yeah,
versus,
it's like a little bit healthier.
Yeah, versus like a bunch of bourbon. I want to take it on the bourbon train.
Then you're going to want old fashions.
Yeah.
Actually,
I don't know.
I personally
love old fashions.
I do. I love them. They're so good.
I love them too, but like I also just love bourbon straight.
Yeah. I feel you. I mean, you can't like drink like too many old fashions, or it's like a little bit.
On a little cinnamon.
Yeah. Afternoon parfait time. Oh, this has been my go-to. I think like 4 days in a row at like 3:30, I get really hungry.
But like the wind must have blown it open. I didn't leave it. We didn't walk out of the house with it. Like,
you don't lock it though.
I normally do. Anytime I go in and out, don't tell me what I do and don't do.
I live with you. I know exactly what you do and don't do. What are you talking about?
You don't think I lock the doors? Come have a seat with me.
Okay. I feel like your spouse like knows your habits best because. I know, right? I'm telling you, it's amazing, and it's so clean. I think it's like. Maybe the food cooks together, it's really balanced. You cannot have this parfait without the bananas.
So is the
don't even try.
Almond butter.
So is the almond butter. Every element is important.
I was getting so tired in the facial. I felt bad because she was trying to talk to me, but I was like, she'd ask me a question and she didn't realize I was like almost asleep. Or maybe she did and that's why she would ask me a question. She didn't want me falling asleep on her. I was so tired. When you get relaxed, you're just kind of sitting there. There's not many opportunities throughout the day where you like close your eyes for a moment.
I know.
You know, and so when you do, you're like, oh,
I
can just like relax.
Yeah.
So good.
I know, it's hard to like take that time.
The dollar wall looks pretty good.
It does look good. I feel like the light frames might look better.
I agree.
But
Yeah. Oh, we need to let Schnoz know about our chairs.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
All right, we're going to carry on with the day.
Carry on.
A little bit more work to do, and then we're going to have a chill evening with some delicious fishes. All right. Yeah. All right, next morning, I just got done with F45. Julia doesn't normally work out on Sundays.
I just need a breather, you know?
But Sundays at F45 are actually pretty chill. I actually like it a lot. It's like more focused on the core and like strength, like slow movements rather than a HIIT style workout.
Yeah.
Like fast paced, jumping around and stuff like that. So it's nice on a Sunday to kind of like slow pace, like, you know, take your time and get good workouts in. Anyway, we're making some breakfast.
Sunday brunch.
I just made some bacon. Julia's making some mushrooms and onions.
Mushrooms and onions. I think we do broccoli.
Should we do a fried egg?
And then we do whole fruit salad.
Maybe fried egg or scramble? I think fried.
Well, I was going to do like a veggie scramble. No.
Oh.
Nah.
All right, whatever.
But. We can do whatever.
Now that these, now that this bitch is hung, what?
Oh my god, yeah.
What are your thoughts?
Okay. Well, let me tell you what happened with the frames. Okay, the frames were supposed to be a chocolate medium brown, but they do come off black. But
they are brown.
They are brown.
I didn't know they were brown until like, after they were hung up, and I was like, those are so dark. We shouldn't have got black. And she's like, they're brown, and I looked close, and they are brown.
They're like a cocoa.
They are brown.
They're a cocoa, like a but dark chocolate.
The whole time I thought they were black.
I know. So I didn't want to do the light wood because a lot of people have the light wood on there. I've seen other people like do the
Alcohol. It almost looks like that.
It's really light, and sometimes I think it could come off cheap, but now that I've seen the dark version, I feel like the light might look better. The other thing is that a lot of our frames got cracked because we placed like bags of wood on top of them, so I have to order new ones anyways.
We probably have to order like 7 new ones.
Yeah.
And so it's like,
should I just order the light frames?
Do we replace them?
I think we might as well because I think we're not digging it.
You thought the brown was going to be like this color.
I thought it was going to be
like more of
like a milk chocolate, not a dark
like
chocolate.
Like a cognac.
Yeah, like a warmer, you know, mid-tone brown, like milk chocolate. And this is like a dark chocolate.
Dark chocolate, yeah.
Overswarm. You know what I mean?
But it's I like it. And every day, like, I'm gonna walk in here and wanna fix one of the frames. Like, I already noticed that one up there. It feels like it's like turned that way a little bit, and I wanna like just snatch it right now. And
you need to edit that montage of you when I go, babe, walk away. You need to like do all the clips.
Yeah.
Like me, I'm like, walk away.
She told me to walk away like probably for 45 minutes, and I just couldn't. I couldn't.
You couldn't live on.
Well, when it's like projects like this, I take pride in them. And I'm a perfectionist when it comes to like.
No, I like that about you. Because if I did the whole house, it'd be like a hodgepodge. It'd be like a hot mess.
So. Well, like just honestly, like even like anything I build or put together, I'm a perfectionist.
I know.
Like with measurements and stuff like that.
No, I think it's a great quality.
Well, in any kind of like woodworking or like thing that you have to build.
Yeah.
If something's off by like just a tad, it can screw up everything.
I know. No, and that's how it should be.
And that's like part of like the craftsmanship.
Yeah.
Even though I'm not really a craftsman, but I do want to build a boat at some point. I have the goal. I know it's a joke that I have that book on how to build a boat. I have that because, like, I will build a boat at some point.
I feel like I maybe see you building a boat more. It's going to be more of a dad vibe, is my vision.
Yeah, you know, for
like,
sure.
I see you doing that, like, maybe even when you're retired.
Really?
Yeah, like, I don't know if it'll
see,
be
either you. Part of me wants to build it with like my grandfather.
With him?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, that would be good. Because I think by yourself would be a little bit of a, I could totally see you doing it.
I mean, I feel like it'd be a fun project with him once I have like more time on my hands.
For sure. Yeah, you just don't really have the time for that. That's why I was thinking more of a retirement.
No, totally. Yeah. I think I want to build a canoe. I've been really inspired over the past, like, I think I found this guy like 5 years ago. His name is Trent Pretzler, I think his name. I'll put his Instagram on the screen. But he makes and sells like $250,000 canoes.
Yeah.
I showed you him before, remember?
Yeah.
He's a canoe guy. But yeah. He sells his canoes now for like $200,000.
That much?
Yeah, like it's like a high-end client that buys his canoes. And they're like crap. Like he like,
people?
It takes him a long, long time to build these canoes. And it's like, you know, multi-millionaires buy his canoes.
Yeah.
Anyway.
That's a lot of money for a canoe.
I know. So they might as well build a real one.
Right.
But yeah, I think there's something cool about the craftsmanship of building a boat that floats. Like, that's like, I'm serious. Like,
a boat that floats.
There's very few people that can build a boat, and there's even fewer people that can build one that floats.
Well, yeah, I mean, that's the point, right?
Anyway. All
right. Well, I have to say, when you walked in from your workout, I was kind of like, oh, I'm jealous. Like, you're probably feeling really good right now.
Yeah, my body's like, you know that kind of like high, but you're tired? Like,
yeah. See,
I can feel like my shoulders and stuff are sore.
Kind of throbbing.
But I like today because it was like so much core.
Yeah, no, that's nice. But I guess I did that core workout the other day, so like.
Oh, yeah. You got that done. I didn't do that.
Yeah. But.
I am tired though.
Yeah, I know, I'm tired too. And I just feel, you realize when you work out, like you move like the stale energy like out of your body.
I almost wish there was like 11 o'clock class on Sundays.
Yeah.
But I feel like if it was 11 o'clock class on Sundays, you'd wake up and you'd be like, I'm going to get some breakfast. And then after breakfast, you're like, oh, I don't want to work out.
I know.
Like, you kind of just have to get up and go.
No,
there's an 8 o'clock class and a 9 o'clock class. And
you definitely just have to.
I woke up at 8.
Like,
what's the 9?
You could literally talk yourself out of working out every single day.
Every day.
Like, you just have to go. It's, I think in the whole year that we've worked out,
yeah.
I don't think I've ever.
I noticed that the mornings, like, it's nice because you get in and you get it done. And you don't question it, you just go.
Yeah.
The evenings I have more energy, and I feel like I get a better workout in almost.
Yes.
But the chances of me going
are a little bit slimmer.
The percentage of me going goes down.
Wait, is slimmer a word or is it more slim?
Slim. Yeah,
more
it's
slim.
More slim, yeah.
Yeah. I know.
Like, because you have more chances throughout the day for like things to come up.
Yeah.
Or to make up excuses and talk yourself out.
I mean, you really can.
Although I do like evening workouts, morning workouts are like.
Where's that?
It's almost more promising.
Definitely.
Oh, my stomach is growling. I'm hungry. And I'm tired. I'm gonna shower after this and then. We're gonna keep doing house stuff today.
Yeah.
We just have been doing
a
lot of house stuff.
I got to clean the closet today and organize it. Like, it has to happen.
Yeah, Julie's gonna unpack her bag from Texas from 3 weeks ago.
Yeah. I think more than 3 weeks. I think it's like a month.
I mean, strike through your album.
I opened the suitcase. It's a step in the right direction. I opened it, pulled something out. So now it's open, ready to unpack. That's, you know, it's a win in my head. Oops, I just pulled some papers. Really into fruit salads on Whole 30. I know that you're like,
you know that sure. You know that cartoon show for kids and it was like fruit salad yummy yummy?
No.
Fruit salad yummy yummy.
No.
What's that from?
Wait, let's turn this down. Are you you're not
what is that? Any of y'all know what that is? It was like, oh, was it the Wiggles? Was the Wiggles a show?
Should have said that.
I just know that I know like those kids' shows because my brother and sister and I, we were the oldest of all of our cousins until my cousins watched these shows. And just like now, I know like some little kid shows from my brother's kids and stuff like that. But I think it was called The Wiggles. Was Wiggles a show?
I don't remember that. It's not ringing a bell for me. Okay. Are you, you're going to eat breakfast then shower, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
How long is the broccoli going to take?
5 minutes. So do you want to do the egg situation?
Yeah, well, I mean, I was going to maybe do some fried eggs, but you don't want fried eggs?
Well, I just thought that.
What if we did fried eggs on one of those piece of gluten-free toasts?
Well, okay. And just like a veggies on the side?
Yeah.
Okay, you can do. I'm gonna do a little scramble for
okay, I'll do then. Scramble. I'll do a scramble.
No, it's okay.
No, it's just easier to do it all together.
Mm-hmm.
I'll compromise.
Oh, stop. Clearly, we have compromised. I'll just compromise.
Oh, I heard that if you just drop an egg into a pan, it like cracks perfectly.
Really?
Wanna try it?
Wait, with the shell?
Yeah, and then you just pull the shell off.
Okay, hold on. Let's get in close to this. 1 second.
I'm
gonna
try.
Oh god, if this messes up.
Because I'm just gonna crack.
Wait. Do we need some like slide in there?
Well, wasn't the baking grease in here?
Yeah, I mean, it should be fine, right?
And I'm just gonna mix the eggs in.
Okay.
They're in here. All right, ready?
Okay.
Oh, that didn't work.
Well, I mean, kind of, but then yeah, you have to pick out the shells.
No, but I thought it was like supposedly like the yolk doesn't crack either.
Oh. Interesting. Huh, not bad.
Anyway, all right. Wait, this one was open.
Oh, it's fine. I just cracked it a little bit last night.
But I'm sorry. Accident. Just give me another. Sorry. Sorry.
This is food waste.
I thought it was cracked. That's bad.
It's cracked because I cracked it.
I didn't know that.
So you just pull it back out of the garbage and you use it. Mm. That's what I'm saying. Yeah, exactly. You're making excuses.
I didn't. What did you say?
Okay, time to make this bed and clean the bathroom and closet. I really don't want to do this right now. It's like the last thing I want to do, but I feel like I've been avoiding it for so long that it needs to happen. So, oh, by the way, I know I'm going to get questions on these sweats. I already tagged them on my stories. They are Brandy Melville, the flared style at the bottom. And they don't name their colors, so this one's just like, it's like the taupe color. They don't have names for them, so I can't even list the color for you. But yeah, they're just like a wide leg sweat, and I like them, very comfortable. But it sucks because I can't link Brandy Melville and Like to Know It, so I can never save it. That's why I like using Like to Know It, because it's just like a library to save all the links. You guys can always refer back to outfits, so it's kind of annoying, but whatever. More steady right there. Okay. This is what's gonna take a little bit. It's not that bad, but still a work in progress. It's just like jewelry, shoes, whatever. But I ordered these clear acrylic kind of dividers on Amazon for my handbags. And I'm going to try and do them on the top level there. I feel like that's a good spot for them. We're going to try. Let's see how it goes. First. Okay, that worked out really well. I feel like it's already just like, wow, there's a spot for it. I have to get all my other bags though, and like, I'm kind of refining. I keep a lot of them in my office like for videos and just like daily wear. So I need to bring a lot of them in here, but I'm gonna do the other side next. Alrighty, it's as good as it's getting for now. And I'm actually pretty happy with it. I'm gonna be selling some handbags. These are any handbags that I
decided just not to keep in the collection as I'm like moving through. A lot of them, most of them aren't designer. And I'm realizing now, like, I really don't have that many, as many bags as I thought. And it kind of makes me think like, oh, I want to build the collections. It's more well-rounded. You know what I mean? Anyways, people are probably like, okay, whatever. But I think it looks pretty good. And that just makes me feel a lot better. Like, having them all up there, I could never see them. They're all scattered all over the place. So, looks pretty good. Next, I need to do another sweep of the closet. And I would love to, like, get rid of more things. But it's for another day. I just don't have the energy
right now. So, today, very excited. There is a makeup artist that I have been following on Instagram. She is so good. She's like, has a kind of a smaller account, so you probably haven't seen her before. But she does like really fresh, glowy makeup. She's obviously like a makeup artist, but she kind of, I feel like most makeup artist accounts are really hard to follow, and she does kind of more user. No. Do you think I'm talking to you?
Huh?
Do you think I'm talking to you?
Yeah, I couldn't hear you. I didn't know you were doing vlogging already.
Who do you think I'm talking to? Just to myself? I talk to my phone all day. That's what I do. So, anyways.
Tell me that it's short.
What?
Tell me that it's short.
Okay, so she, like I was saying, is, yeah, really good makeup artist. I was saying that makeup artists usually are a little bit harder to follow because they're so advanced, but I feel like she really kind of breaks it down for people. So anyways, she's a really, if you guys like my style of makeup, you'll love her style of makeup. It's like the same vibe. It's just all fresh and like pretty natural, like nothing's really crazy. So I've been following her. Anyways, she ended up coming to Nashville this week, and she's here for a few days and was like, hey, I'd love to come glam you. And I was like, oh, yes. So she's coming over in a bit. So I'm just making the bed, kind of cleaning up the house. And, yeah, we're going to do makeup. So I'm so excited. I'll introduce you guys and vlog a little bit so you can see the process. But I basically like I found her account right around the Sephora sale, so I literally bought so many things from her recommendation. Sorry, I'm like trying to make my bed and vlog at the same time. This is like not working. Anyways, she's just really great. You'll see her when she gets here, but I'm just cleaning up. Okay, I'm gonna shut up because this is like annoying probably. It's like a back and forth and back and forth. Here we go.
I hate these. I know, that's why. I'm trying to figure these shorts out. They're Gymshark. And I haven't really, I think I've worn them once to the gym when I first got them in Texas.
Yeah.
Because they're like, they're almost like sweatshirt material or like cotton, like t-shirt material.
Yeah.
So they're comfortable. But the fitting is really weird. Actually, you can't really see.
They're more narrow.
They're like narrow at the bottom, which I think is more of like a, I think a European thing. Where like their thighs are thick, thick AF, and they're like wear their shorts like this when they do like squats and shit. I don't know. To me, it just feels weird. But I guess they look okay. Look weird in the ass probably. Anyway, I canceled my 8:30 class to go with you.
To go with me where?
To the gym.
You don't have to do that.
I know, but it motivates both of us if we go together.
Alright.
Motivates her.
What?
Huh?
What did you say?
I didn't say anything.
Yes, you did.
I did not say anything.
What did you say?
I said I love my wife.
That's not what you said. Spoiled bitch?
No, I didn't spoil a bitch.
What did you say? You said something.
I sneezed.
Mm-hmm.
I was sneezing.
No, you weren't.
Okay, I showered last night, but should I shower?
What did you say, bitch?
Nothing.
What did you say?
I said it motivates her.
No, tell me.
That's what I said. I said it
for real?
I said it motivates us to go together, and then you like called me. I was like,
no, you didn't.
Okay, watch the cutback.
Hmm. Whatever. You, like, I don't need the motivation. No.
See, that's why I said it in my breath, because I don't want you to get defensive.
I'm not defensive. No, I mean, I do like the motivation. Honestly, I do.
You like going together. It's nice, especially evening workouts. It's like, it's hard to get yourself to go. So
honestly, I was at the gym yesterday. Hunter and I had to separate stations because we got there late. And I was in between, like, two people that were, they were lagging a little, to be honest, which, no shade, but when you're, like, you need motivation, the people next to you are, like, stopping 30 seconds in, you're like, bitch, come on, like, I need some motivation, too, like, I need you to keep going. That's and I feel like I was carrying the pod.
That's why I like being together.
What?
I'm a pod carrier.
I carry my pod.
But that's what I'm saying, I'm a pod carrier, and when I'm with you,
gym leaders.
I bring you along. We are gym leaders. We're athletes.
Athlete, gym leader, head trainer, whatever you want to say.
Gym sergeant.
Right.
Gym shark. We're gym sharks.
We're the captains.
Captains of the gym.
Of the gym, you know.
Exactly.
We boost the morale. Right.
Exactly. We're like the cheerleaders.
Pod lead. You know, being a leader is a tough position to be in. It's a lot of effort.
It's a lot of mental toughness.
Yes, it is. And it takes a special person to be a leader.
It does. We've become that.
Yeah.
Do you want me to order proper bagels coffee?
Well, I just made a coffee. I made you your espresso.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Oh, beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so yeah. And then I'm also filming a little video today for Lulu's. It is a wedding guest dress guide, and that was kind of one of the reasons why I was like, oh cool, if you want to come do my makeup, I am shooting a video today, so that was perfect timing. And I have a lot of really cute, kind of like classic simple wedding guest dresses. That's kind of the path I feel like I've been evolving to. It's so nice outside. I'm like, it's literally like a summer day. But yeah, I've been, I think my style more and more, I've been leaning into like classic, more timeless pieces, and then I'll accessorize or like play with trends, but the core of my wardrobe, I want it to be, you know, pretty streamlined, things that don't really go out of style, like bodycon dresses, like the ribbed Windsor dress, or like a silk oversized shirt, a pair of denim, a leather jacket, and then we can play in fun colors right now, like for spring and summer, and then, you know, as trends come and go, you can kind of pop them in and out, but having like the basics as your core, I feel like it's been the thing. So kind of went for those shapes in the dresses as well, because I feel like for weddings, that's perfect. You don't want to like do anything crazy. Anyways.
Then can we go on a walk this afternoon?
Yeah, after I'm
done. Because today's like a sunny day.
Yeah.
I want to go on like a, maybe we can do Radnor Lake again, but go like up one of those trails.
Okay.
Just trying to lead us.
We were really sore and we were really tired.
Yeah.
But then it was like fine, but apparently the second one is like the kicker.
Yeah, I've heard that one really.
I want to capture this really fast.
Okay, I'm pushing up your brows like Jess Hunt, and I think they're gonna be intense.
We're basically like, we want to look like Jess Hunt.
We
want to
be
today.
Jess Hunt so bad.
Did you know that her hair is naturally blonde too? She said.
What ethnicity is she?
I don't know.
Because I feel like she has like Swedish in her or something.
Totally, it's like that like brown skin with like blonde hair. It's such a pretty.
Do you have her brow products?
I do not.
I want to get them. We need to get them. They're Refi or whatever.
I know. I kind of feel like she just has good brows and she used it to her advantage to launch a product. I mean, I'm not saying that the products aren't good, but you
know. We need to test them.
Yeah, we'll test them.
Is she, like, she's not based in America, right?
I don't. She's British. British. I'm pretty sure, yeah. Okay, this is Kellyanne, by the way.
Hi.
I'll put her Instagram here.
Are you doing YouTube?
I'm doing YouTube. Okay. We're just vlogging this week.
Love.
And I thought I would capture this for you guys. She is using the Got To Be glue to push up my brows.
They're like Elmer's glued up.
Literally.
Look how intense they are.
Wow.
If you don't like them, shape the edges like this.
I like it.
I think it's
I just trim them, so if they aren't trimmed, it's literally like, holy crap,
that's
a little scary, but
they're iconic.
Good.
You have amazing brows too.
Thank you.
Are these like, you just grown them out?
They're literally just like, since third grade, I have like a full unibrow, and like my whole family, just like our brows are just really thick. And it's really weird because I actually, like my head hair is really fine and thin, but
really?
I just like have these random brows that are like so crazy.
Well, good for you, because they're back in style.
No, I know. It's
definitely lucky, but
people pay for this, like they like microblade this on.
It is, it's definitely nice, but sometimes, you know, we all get like one thing that's kind of our good thing.
Smash. I'll show you guys a close-up in the light. You can see it now.
I'm like strained holding these back.
The nose contour. I know. This is like the life of a makeup artist. Look at her.
So heavy.
She's got so much stuff.
Wait, so you like your makeup?
I'm obsessed. Yeah. Like, it's my favorite
ever.
Wow,
it really does kind of, like, not wash you out, but the camera takes away so much.
The camera just, yeah, it's different. But no, I think it looks perfect.
It looks fire.
The cheek.
Yeah, the glow.
It's so good.
I love you.
I love you too. Give me a hug.
Thank you so much.
Of course. Seriously.